in the this session of 2014-15, we are looking forward with a very good team of board members having definite agenda to achieve, and I being given the responsibility of communication. The two major things which will be creating a lot of internal and external communication avenue will be created, so that we will be getting closer to each other and we will be informed all the time. Secondly, we are going to bring forward the newsletter which we were getting through the emails which were possibly I may be missing it most of the times, or I am not that interested to go through it. So we are looking forward to make it a newspaper in a physical format and bringing things more lively and engaging people, so that they feel proud, they feel engaged, they feel they are connected with past, future events and what is going around in Jaipur, all around the world. So these two things will definitely add value to the chapter. Thank you.
Next with the series is our dynamic spousal champion, Mrs. Kriti Agrawal, who took the responsibility to take up the spousal to be involved more in EO this year. Kriti.
To all the members and their parents, I'm working towards involving the spouses and children more into our event, the spouses and the children. So please feel free to contact me and support me and make your suggestions. Thank you so much.
IE, that's Area Integration Event, which is known as Mini RI, to be held in November 2014 in Jaipur. For this, I would like to call upon Navneet Mathur, our EIO chair and my EIO chair, to explain and provide more details on this. Navneet.
An absolute pleasure to announce that Jaipur has been awarded the first area integration event that is going to take place for the very first time in the entire region. In 2010, when Jaipur got the opportunity to host the RIE, it was an unprecedented event. We created an ambience, environment, experience that was never given before. All RIEs took place in corporate events, but when Jaipur took over, the experience that we gave to all the participants was exceptional. We had locations which are, actually we are blessed by such locations. We had the bonding, we had the networking, we had the opportunity. So what we would like to do is, we would like to host this event in the same spirit. We would rather take it to a next level, for which what we have done so far is, we have created some sort of a white paper, some committees, and we are looking for all the 53 people to participate equally in that. Under the presidency of Deepak Datta, we would like to make this event something that is going to be very unique. Our focus will be to give an experience that EOers are never going to get anywhere else. So we are blessed with such places. We are blessed with the spirit of our chapter. So we look forward. Please do help us in volunteering. Please do raise your hand. Please be the go-getter. Please be the one who will boldly go and support us in this endeavor to make this event a world-class one. We are going to have participants from all across the states, all across the chapters, which is going to give us an opportunity to flagship our chapter as one of the most fascinating, one of the most hospitable chapters that we have in the region. So I look forward for all of you to raise your hand and help in every possible manner that you can. And also thank you, Kriti, for volunteering to take part in all the spousal activities and ensuring that all the guest spouses have a great time. So please do reach out, and when we reach out to you, please do raise your hand and help us in all possible ways. Thank you.
I promise to do our best throughout our year, and I request everyone to participate and make this year a memorable one. Na pucho ki meri manzil kahan hai, abhi to safar ka irada kiya hai. सितारों को छू लेना है, ये मैंने किसी और से नहीं, खुद से ही ये वादा किया है. Finally, I would like to call upon our learning chair, Madhu Khetan, to give insight on the learning events which gonna happen this year and take us through the evening. Madhu.
Thank you,
But before I start, I want to request all of you. I think we should all really respect the time. We should all arrive on time. अब मुझे दीपक ने जब मास्टर जी का पदवी दी है तो शायद मैं सबको रिप्रोमांड भी कर सकता हूँ. No, like get out of the class, kneel down, blah blah blah. So guys, as part of the learning calendar, we have very nice events lined up. We start with Madam Shabana asked me today. We have Eric Maddox, who talks about negotiation skills. He was working with the United States of America to negotiate Saddam Hussein, and which he did end of the day. He's going to come and speak to us in August. We have Kumar Vishwas. We have Mr. Amit Jatia, who's the owner of McDonald's India. Then we have in November AIE that Deepak has announced. Further on, we'll have Mr. Piyush Pandey coming to speak about, and then Mr. Amish Tripathi. We have a lot of speakers whom we are discussing, they're finalized. We have to allocate dates to them. Sunny Leone, Dhatat Sharma, Aapki Adalat. Harish Sagar, who's an eminent lawyer. Mr. Tucker, who's going to talk about how to handle income tax rates. I think it's very important for all the people sitting here. And then Mr. Berman, who's an eminent speaker who talks about family business. He's established, he's a patriot, running a very large family business in India. He's the chairman of Dabur Industries. And then we, of course, have Kriti, who's going to organize three events, which is focused towards the spouses and the kids. Today, we have the opportunity to also announce, with Deepak's perseverance, Star Forum Award. From now on, there are going to be no day chairs. Each forum will be given a responsibility to host an event the way they like. They'll be allocated a budget. And there'll be an award criteria for the forum for involvement in EO. At the end of the year, whichever forum wins, will be given 1.5 lakhs from the board as a fund to enjoy in their own forum. So thank you, Deepak, for giving us that opportunity. We have a small AV to play.
And veteran theatre actress Shaukat Azmi on 18 September 1951. Shabana had a natural inclination towards intellectual growth. She completed her graduation from St. Xavier's College, Mumbai, followed by a course in acting at the Film and Television Institute of India, Pune. She even went on to win the National Film Award for Best Actress. Her next film, Nishant, was a huge success and won many international awards. Her phase of success continued with films like Fakira, Shatranj Ke Khiladi, Amar Akbar Anthony, Junoon, Swami and Sparsh. Another film that defined her career as a talented actress was Arth, which was about extramarital relationships. The film was such a huge success that it won Shabana the Film Fest at the Chicago International Film Festival. She has been a part of many foreign films and projects as well, for which she received attention in the international arena. In the film Godmother, released in 1998, Shabana Azmi played the character inspired by Santokh Ben Jadeja, a lady heading an underworld enterprise in India. The film won 6 national awards, including the award for Best Actress, which went to Azmi. Shabana played the...
Communication AV, which will be part of the feature of every event, and also do the backdrop. So thank you, Mr. Roomta. Thank you, Switchin. And thank you to our... As we all know, Madam Shabana Azmi is married to India's best-known scriptwriter, lyricist Javed Akhtar. Madam Azmi is an activist, an artist, a wife, and I think there is nobody better amongst us to truly talk about managing work and family. As we wait for Madam Azmi, I want to bring some memories back from last Red Board. I remember when we started with Sharad, the first day he had a goal that the only one thing that we have to bring to EO Jaipur is the bonding, and that's the only way to bring that is to achieve rock star create practices that are at par with global standards. And as many of you did miss the President's Ball, I want to let you know that we are amongst the highest scoring chapter across South Asia
on a scale of 8.2, am I right, Sharad?
Yes.
In terms of member satisfaction, we are the, a lot of practices that we made last year were benchmarked. For example, the membership process, for example, the sponsorship that Mr. Manav Podar got for us, 21 lakhs, with help of Mr. Jitendra Agarwal as a sponsorship chair. So these are benchmarks that we have created, and I think that's come with teamwork. Thank you, Sharad. Thank you very much. With Deepak in place, I think we all were joking about it at the bar, at the back, but when two datas combine every time, you know, we have an RIE or an AIE coming along. So this is a record that is going to be very hard to break. I don't know when Amol comes, probably new after 20, 30 years, he's going to say, mere papa ke time mein kuch aisa hua tha. So these are interesting times, a lot of hard work for Navneet, a lot of hard work for the chapter to come and get involved for AIE. It's an event, as you all know, it's a mini RIE. I think Deepak has been considered enough to contribute from the chapter side to make it very viable for all the chapter members to attend. So I thank you, Deepak, for that. This is an event where we'll have probably a day or a two-day event where people from other chapters will come down to Jaipur. We will host them. There'll be speaking sessions, which is the keynote speaker. There'll be breakout sessions. And of course, we'll have some games to compete in terms of chapter. You know, last year we lost in the cricket match. That was unfortunate because I kind of dragged my own self into the team for bowling. So, guys, thank you. And I think we have to wait for Madam Azmi.
No money is enough. We are short by half of what we want. So that would be a certainly welcome idea.
So guys, as part of EO benefits, let me just tell you, I don't know how many of you... So there's an opportunity. Yeah, you should all sign up for Taj. It's a Taj Gold card, which is available to all EO members. Okay, who has the Regus card for accessing meetings across India and global when you're traveling? Regus card, guys? Gold Regus card? So you all can get gold Regus card. So there are many benefits that you all can get. Mrs. Yashvi Khaitan.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. About empowerment of women, but backing, it doesn't work. What we need to do is to walk shoulder to shoulder with each other. When we talk about the position of women today, and the position of men in our society, and especially amongst young people as are present today, it becomes evident that if we are to look forward to a good future, a future that is healthy for our children, as antagonists but walk together, shoulder to shoulder. More than 60 years ago, my father, Kefi Azmi, wrote a poem called Aurat, in which he said, Zindagi jahad mein hai, sabr ke kaabu mein nahi, urne khulne mein hai nikhat, hame yesu mein nahi, jannat ek aur hai jo mard ke pehlu mein nahi, uski azaad ravish par bhi machalna hai tujhe, kuch meri jaan, meri saath hi chalna hai tujhe. So the key word, इसके हमको साथ चलना है. Now I think all of us know that India is a country that lives in several centuries simultaneously. We have people living back to back in the 19th, 20th and 21st century. Multi-religious, multicultural, multi-ethnic society, and so it is with the position of women. So on the one hand, when we look at the progress that our country has made, we can hold our heads high and say there has been a lot of progress. Also, when it comes to the position of women, we've had a woman prime minister very early in our career. We've had a woman president. We have so many women who are important politicians. There are women who are going out and working. There are women in politics. But the sad fact is also that female feticide is still practiced in our country today. Not as you and I would imagine in the back of beyond, in some tiny little village, but in metropolitan cities like Mumbai, like Delhi, Haryana, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Mehsana, what have you. This must change. This must change. Amongst the many things that we need to do when we walk together is that we have to see that the basically patriarchal mindset that we have in our society, where a boy is privileged over the girl right from birth, just for dint of being a boy, leads to a whole lot of discrimination against the girl child. When we look at the audience today, we can well say, well, these are the privileged few. These are the people who are working. They're working at home. They're working outside. And they haven't suffered from discrimination. But let's look at whether that is actually a fact. I would like to ask you, all of you, most of whom are working, ye bataiye ke aap dono kaam karte hain, miyan bhi kaam karte hain, biwi bhi kaam karte hain. Agar ghar mein bachcha bimar hai, to ghar pe kaun rahega? Jawab do, maa ya pita? Bataiye.
Maid.
Is that a fact?
Mother.
Who would have been? Mother. क्यों? क्योंकि औरत का काम और उसका profession कम है मर्द के हिसाब से. क्यों? ये कब हुआ? ये किसने फैसला तय किया? ये कब हमने तय कर लिया कि नहीं, औरत जो है ठीक है, मर्द बेसिकली काम करता, औरत घर में एक और आमदनी करने के लिए घर में बैठती है, कुछ फैशन, कुछ ज्वेलरी, कुछ इस तरह का काम कर लेती है. इट्स अ सप्लीमेंट्री थिंग, इट कीप्स हर बिजी, शी गेट डजंट गेट ऑन माय नर्व, तो ठीक है जो भी कर रही है. और इज इट अ फैक्ट दैट वी डीपली रिस्पेक्ट द वर्क दैट द वुमन इज डूइंग? हाउ डज इट स्टार्ट? वेयर डज दिस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन स्टार्ट? इन दिनों में मैंने जो है कुछ थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड की टेक्स्ट बुक्स देखी, उनमें एक सवाल हमेशा होता है, माँ कहाँ है? जवाब होता है, माँ रसोई घर में. उसी के साथ दूसरा सवाल होता है, पिता कहाँ है? जवाब होता है, पिता दफ्तर में. तो मैं पूछती हूँ कि ये क्यों नहीं हो सकता कि सवाल ये हो कि माँ कहाँ है, जवाब हो माँ दफ्तर में है, और ये क्यों नहीं हो सकता कि सवाल हो पिता कहाँ है और जवाब हो पिता रसोई घर में. ये क्यों नहीं हो सकता कि पिता और माता दोनों दफ्तर में भी हैं और पिता और माता दोनों रसोई घर में भी हैं? ये हमने क्यों तय कर लिया है एक 3 साल के बच्चे के लिए? ये क्यों तय कर लिया है कि द चाइल्ड इज डेस्टिन्ड टू बिलीविंग दैट द वुमन्स प्लेस इज इन द हार्ट एंड दैट ऑफ द मैन इज आउटसाइड द होम? सोली वी नीड टू चेंज दैट एंड वी नीड टू लुक विद इन आवरसेल्व्स. एंड आई थिंक व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट एम्पावरमेंट, it is impossible to have empowerment of women, which is a desired goal, unless you change the notion of masculinity in the man. Why does masculinity mean all about showing outwardly strength, about having a six-pack ab, about being like really aggressive? Why isn't it also about compassion? Why isn't it also about consideration? Why isn't masculinity also not measured by the degree to which a man is compassionate? Why are we creating a society in which we are saying that there are clear divisions for men and for women? Maybe in earlier times, जब ऐसा था कि मर्द जो है जाके कमाता था और बीवी घर पर बैठती थी, तो शायद उस वक्त चलता है. लेकिन आज के दौर में जब हम देखते हैं तो औरतें भी काम कर रही हैं, गांव में भी काम करती हैं, घर में भी, शहरों में भी काम करती हैं, और जब ये काम करती हैं तो उनके काम की जितनी इम्पोर्टेंस है उस इम्पोर्टेंस को हमें कबूल करना पड़ेगा. विच मीन्स बेसिकली What we're looking for is not a battleground, not a battleground between sexes, but a renegotiation of the relationship. So that we say that what we want and what we're deriving for is a notion of how families are run, in which we desire much more male participation. I can see some young men looking rather horrified by what I'm saying. मैंने जब ये पार्लियामेंट में बात उठाई थी तो मर्द ने कहा था कि नहीं, अगर हम लोग रसोई घर में चले जाएंगे तो फिर खाना तो खाया ही नहीं जाएगा. लेकिन ये सही नहीं है, क्योंकि इफ यू लुक एट द बेस्ट शेफ्स इन द वर्ल्ड, ऑल ऑफ देम आर मेल. सो देयर इज नो प्री डिटरमाइंड रोल दैट इज प्राइमरीली मेल, एंड देयर इज नो प्री डिटरमाइंड रोल दैट इज प्राइमरीली फीमेल. व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज अ अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ हाउ वी ट्रीट other human beings, whether it is our daughter, whether it is our mother, whether it is our wife, whether it's our partner, whether it's our sister. In Indian society, it's very easy. People say ki hum to aapko devi ki tarah poochte hain, aapko kya shikayat ho sakti hai. To main kehti hu ki main devi banna hi nahi chahti, aap mujhe devi na samjhe, aap mujhe equal treat kare. Wo zyada mushkil kaam hai. देवी बना देना बहुत आसान है, क्योंकि आपने एक पेडेस्टल पे रख दिया, बाद में मैं आपको वर्शिप करता हूँ, उसके बाद आपको कोई इक्वालिटी की बात ही नहीं करनी पड़ेगी. तो द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज इन एनी सोसाइटी, इफ वी हैव टू से दैट दिस इज अ सोसाइटी दैट वी रिस्पेक्ट, देन इट हैज टू बी अ सोसाइटी इन विच मेन एंड वुमेन कम टूगेदर. दीज डेज वी हैव सीन दैट देयर हैज बीन, एंड दिस इज अ मैटर ऑफ कंसर्न फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस, that we can see that there is an increasing state of violence in our society. Let's look at the root cause of it. A, that violence against women has the tacit approval of society all over the world. B, that the pressure to keep the marriage alive under all circumstances is probably responsible for the continued abuse and violence that a woman in a certain situation faces. For instance, there have been times without number when we call ourselves progressive and we say hum log educated aur padhe likhe hain, jahan aisa pata chalta hai ki ladki ko thappad mara uske shohar ne. Now the parents, instead of saying there's zero tolerance for it, there is no way that you will go back into a house in which you are slapped, they say बुरे मूड में होगा, पति तो है, he must, you can't leave him just because he slapped you once. This ingrained idea of what a woman should accept, that needs to change. You know, in the spate of the December gang rape, there was a lot of hue and cry about how we need to have more women in police stations, as if that would solve the problem. The fact is that just by dint of having a woman in the police station, it doesn't mean that anything is going to be changed, because she is also a product of that patriarchal culture. And I'll tell you an instance. एक मर्तबा ऐसा हुआ कि एक औरत slums में रहती थी, उसको बहुत बुरी तरह से उसके पति ने पीटा. She had a black eye and she had a broken arm. Now there was a women's group that decided that she should go and lodge a complaint against her husband. And she went there was a woman police officer there. And instead of being sympathetic to this woman and accepting that, listen, she's come under these circumstances, she really needs to be treated with consideration, the woman police officer said, kya kiya tumne aaj, kya kiya jiski wajah se tumhare pati ne tumko mara, she said kuch nahi. So you see, he's not mad, he just doesn't beat you up for any reason at all. Kya kiya tumne, to wo titter ke usne kaha, actually what happened is I washed the clothes and I put them out on the clothes line, and it started raining and I forgot to take the clothes out. So police officer jo aurat hai kehti hai, dekha, I told you it was your fault. This is chilling. This is frightening. This is frightening that such an act is perceived even by a woman as something that is her fault. Why? Because it's a patriarchal society and it's a patriarchal mindset in which we are internalizing certain concepts and taking it for granted, which we need to remove from inside ourselves. actually understand that any society can be healthy only if men and women together work not as a battle of sexes, but renegotiate their entire relationship so that parenting is not just the work of the woman. That parenting also includes not just an absent father, but a hands-on father. And I can see that amongst the young men today, there has been a lot of change in this area. When I look at my own son, Farhan, and I look at the hands-on father he is, in spite of being such a busy man, with his two daughters, I feel heartened, and I feel that this is a good trend, and that is something that should happen. A lot of women feel very guilty about being ambitious. They feel, jab tak ghar ki boat rock nahi karte, jab tak ek supplementary kaam kar lete, to bas hai. Kyun supplementary kaam karte? Kyun full-fledged nahi hoga wo kaam? Why in privileged societies, like somebody said, that who stays at home is the maid? It's very good if we can afford a maid. But when you have so much help, then why isn't it that we respect each other's work and put a value to that work in which we say, sometimes you and sometimes me. It can't always be you. It can't always be me. These are a few thoughts that I thought that I would leave with you. And I don't think that there is a mic. I had asked for a mic. Is there a mic? So that if anybody wants to ask questions, I'll be very happy. Yeah. Yes, please. आपने माइक उठाया आप इस पहला सवाल चुके
No questions,
very good. चलिए. Yes, please. Just there.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hi. This is Sapna from DNA. One question from my side is, कभी आपने अपने लाइफ में have you faced the battle of sex?
Not really. You see, I was brought up in a family of communists. My father was a member of the Communist Party. And till the age of 9, I lived in a commune, which was basically to school, do all of that. So I didn't really experience it at any personal level. But let me tell you, even when I came into the film industry, I really didn't, they used to treat me like a queer kettle of fish. Kind of reaction. But it was very strange that many, many years later, I was in Montreal for a film festival. It was the International Film Festival. There were 11 of us, 10 of whom were men, and I was the only woman. So they decided to make me the president of the jury. It's the token thing to do. In college, they were going jury member ki chairperson banate. Now the men would all say, oh, our queen, please tell us what to do. We will be your slaves, the beautiful queen, all this. It would go on. None of which would have happened if I had been a maid. So I went along with them. Uske baad jab pehle din, when we sat together to actually decide kya karna hai, I had a very clear view of how we were going to assess the films. And I said, we need to have a certain grid, and this is the way we will do it. And I think we were completely shocked. Because first they felt, arey, we were humoring her all this while, and now she's got an opinion of her. And hum log itne important log hai, ye sirf ek actress hai, aur wo bhi third world country ki aayi hai, aur ye humko batayi. It was so palpable, the prejudice was so palpable, it came as a shock to me, because in India I haven't had to experience it at a personal level, which doesn't mean that I don't know that it actually exists. But that's why I am saying that this exists across the border. And there will be situations in our lives where, I don't know why compromise is looked upon as a very bad word. Compromise koi kharab cheez nahi hai. Har cheez ko battleground nahi bana sakte. Sometimes it's better to compromise if there are other factors which are non-negotiable. So you don't have to be a war zone all the time. That's what I think. Yeah, you wanted to ask this.
Thank you, Shivaji, for being here. It was a wonderful talk.
My question to you is, and just a thought, you know, that, you know, we, when we talk about, let's use a maker, it's like a full-time recognition, but if you, I mean, it's as important as, you know, working, it's
I completely and totally agree with you, and I always tell my women friends, because when I ask them what do, they just say, I'm a housewife. I said, it's not just a housewife is a 24/7 job, and the fact that you are keeping this house together. That's why it's functioning. So it has to have value. My point is, it should be the woman's choice. She chooses to be a housewife, or she chooses to go out and work. It's not an imposition on her by society. So if she is part of the decision-making process, where she decides, no, these are important years and I have to give it to my child, then that has to be respected, and you have to understand that it's because this very strong center is there that the house is moving so smoothly. I have a lot of respect for women who can, who actually decide it's a choice that they want to make, that they want to look out for family. And my salute to the woman, I don't look down upon her in any way at all. And I think she does deserve recognition, and I would like to clap for the housewife, because that's what she's doing. Gee, please.
Good evening, ma'am. My name is Navni Mathur. Right, I was the one who said that. Well, you know, balance. Because you said we have to equate ourselves, we have to walk together. But right now from your talk, it seems like that men are villains.
I don't know. I feel men are as much victims to the patriarchal order that women are. Both of them. It's the patriarchal order which is at fault. And men also function according to notions of men must never cry, men have to be strong, men can never show their emotions. इस वक्त जो है अगर कोई आदमी है अगर वो अपनी बीवी को कहता है कि नहीं तुम काम करो ऐसे भी इंस्टेंसेस होते हैं चेतन भगत ये कहता है कि जब मैंने काम करना शुरू किया सो माय वाइफ वाज गोइंग आउट एंड वर्किंग बिकॉज आई वाज राइटिंग अ बुक एंड आई डिडंट नो वेदर आई वुड अर्न एनी मनी फॉर दैट एट ऑल सो आई वुड स्टे एट होम एंड आई वुड बी अ हाउस हस्बैंड एंड एवरीबॉडी वुड लाफ एट हिम एंड से ये तो हाउस हस्बैंड है एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्चुअली सल्यूटिंग द फैक्ट that he was doing this and allowing his wife to actually go and do something else, he was made to feel embarrassed about it. Like when I said, men are as trapped in the idea of masculinity. And I think that masculinity needs to change because, like in women, I don't think anything should be all male or all female. I think within us, we need to have part female and part male, the yin and the yang. अर्धांगिनी अर्धनारी का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है दैट इज इन आवर वेरी मिक्स बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट सफर्स एंड आई थिंक फॉर मेन इट इज टफ इट्स नॉट इजी एट ऑल बिकॉज लाइक समबडी अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइंड हुज अ मेल सेड दैट आई एम बोर्न इन द रॉन्ग सेंचुरी आई एम अ ब्राह्मण एंड आई एम अ मेल आई शुड हैव बीन अ दलित वुमन बिकॉज ऑल द सेंचुरी इज गोइंग टू द दलित एंड द वुमन बट द फैक्ट इज that men are not to be portrayed as villains. That's not my intention at all. But men must be conscious of the fact that they are born to privilege. And that privilege has to be shared. That's what I mean. Aur main bilkul bhi man nahi hoon, main apne shohar se bahut ishq karta hoon.
Ji. Ma'am, good evening. I want to build on to the theme that you talked about the ideology and societal mindset about men, women, you know, we all have children. I personally have a daughter and a son. And as they all grow up, how do you instill this idea of equality in them? Because, you know, there is a societal pressure where the teachers, as I said, in the school don't think alike. Maybe your parents don't agree with your own ideology as parents and my parents, however that the case may be. Maybe your own children, as they grow up, have a different mindset. But how do you instill this thought process in them as they grow up?
In practice, how you practice it, how you treat your daughter and your son. My brother and I were treated in a way where it never even occurred to me that girls should be treated differently from boys. We were given exactly the same opportunities, we were given the same respect. There was never anything that he got as a privilege or I got less as a girl. And you know, children are really, they're like empty receptacles. Whatever you pour in them, bilkul waise ho jate. डेफिनेटली पीयर ग्रुप का असर होता है, डेफिनेटली स्कूल का असर होता है, लेकिन जो बेसिक असर होता है वो अपने घर का होता है. सो इफ द बॉय सीज हिज मदर एज समबडी हुज बीइंग रिस्पेक्टेड, हिज सिस्टर एज समबडी हुज बीइंग रिस्पेक्टेड, हिज ग्रैंडमदर as somebody who's being respected, whose voice is valued, who is allowed to make judgments about her own life. If he sees that as an example, that's what he'll grow up believing. But if he sees that his wife, his mother is insulted, if he sees that nobody cares for his sister, if he sees these things, these are, you don't even have to articulate them. It's only in the way you raise up your children that these are values that get imbibed. But we have to be, because especially we are looking at a society like ours, which is in a moment of transition, I think it's very important that we put in that extra effort to see ki hum apne ladkon ko aur apni ladkiyon ko is tarah se unki parvarish kare ki unko equality ka pura sense ho. See, they, I think it's time for everybody in society to do their bit, and I would talk about my own film industry. I mean, look at the film industry. Yes, there has definitely been a change in the way women are portrayed. In the early 60s, Main Chup Rahungi was the title of a film. And so, Chup Rehna was considered a virtue for women. After that, it changed. It started changing that we have Insaaf Ki Devi, Zakhmi Aurat, Main Jeene Nahi Dungi, Main Marne Nahi Dungi, Main Pata Nahi Kya Nahi Karne Dungi. Lekin basically, women in drag posing to be. So first we had Rambos and then we had Rambolina. But they were doing exactly the same thing. To bring any degree of complexity of what it means to be a woman or the sensitivity, it really was left to the art cinema to do it. It used to also bother me that Hindi cinema mein kabhi aapko working woman hi nahi nazar aati thi. If you saw Hindi cinema till about even 7 years ago, you would believe all that Indian women do is wear yellow chiffon sarees and dance in the Alps. कोई काम धंधा तो वो कभी करती ही नहीं. अब उसमें बदलाव आने लगा है. Thank God for it. Thank God that at least now you see that women are working, they have a profession, etc. This change is happening. But what happens to this item number that we're talking about? I have problems with the item number. I have problems with it because I believe that the business of cinema is the business of images. So when the camera moves suggestively over a woman's body as she's singing a song, so you see her heaving bosom, shaping, swinging butt, navel going in and out, you are robbing the woman of all autonomy and subjecting her to the male gaze. मगर वो तो एक है जिसने ये किया. Why is it that all of society laps up these item numbers? I have great objections to मैं तंदूरी मुर्गू मुझे गटका लिया अल्कोहल के साथ. I think they're unbearable words. But okay, she did this. She made this choice. Why is it that every शादी everybody is dancing on it? And why is it that 4-year-old children? Look, there's an entire sexualization of children that is happening, and all of us are tapping our feet and dancing to it. What? So somewhere as a society, we can't put the blame only on films. We have to see that society. So I remember going to Miranda House and I said, thinking, why do you dance to these numbers? And they said, but they're basic. I said, but they've got words. What are the words saying? They said, we haven't paid attention to the words. Well, you better pay attention to the words, because it's too easy to put the blame on other sections of society. What we have to do is we have to turn inwards, and all of us have to think ke is cheez ko kis tarah se badalna chahiye. As audiences we are complicit, because agar hum ek tarah ki film dekhein, hum duniya, hum apne paise chhod dein, hum muft mein kaam kar le, hum aisi filmon mein kaam kare jahan humko samajh, hum samajhte hain ki isme something very important is being said, aap usko jaake dekhenge hi nahi to us film ka koi fayda nahi hai. आप जिस तरह की फिल्म को देखेंगे, जिस तरह की फिल्म को सराहेंगे, जो क्वालिटीज वो इंडोर्स कर रही है, उससे फर्क पड़ता है. नाउ इट्स रियली इन द इंटेंशन ऑफ द फिल्म मेकर, बिकॉज आई ऑलवेज से आई गिव the example of my own daughter, Zoya Akhtar. And when she, there's a film called Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara. Did you see it?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, sorry. Now, in that, there is Katrina Kaif, who is a diving instructor. And she comes out in a bikini. Because obviously on the beach, what else would you expect her to? But the camera doesn't linger on her body. It just captures her in mid-shot. What it does, it stops her from being commodified and accepts her as a person who is a professional. So, aapki aankh kaisi hai, aapki nazar kaisi hai, usme aapka intention pata chalta hai. Jis tarah ke ads hum dekhte hain society mein, jis tarah ka commodification auraton ka hota hai us society mein, it's always said that why is a woman, even in film, it's very interesting what is happening in the ad world. Why is it that always to sell stuff, it's always women who are the models to sell anything? And why is it that when we are talking about the kind of advertising we see, again there's a role playing where women are doing certain kinds of jobs. Washing machine uske ghar mein aati to wo kitni khush ho jati, to mard kyun nahi khush hota hai? Kabhi kabhi wo bhi to washing machine mein kapde dal sakta hai. Why is it only given to the woman? Why? And why don't we question it? Why is it something that we just say ki haan aisa ho hota hai? Thoda sa to humko bhi discerning banna padega.
Ma'am, just to build on to that, I think, is it not about a mindset? Because, for example, I studied outside, and the majority of us did. When we were outside, everything, aap kapde bhi khud dhote the university mein, aap khana bhi khud banate the. And when you come back to India, you have this kind of lazy attitude that boss, ab to sab kuch, everything is taken care of, you know, why should I bother? And then, if you look at it, I think, would it be not right that in India, men are fearful that what if my wife is more successful than me? You know what? How do you kind of handle that pressure? And so in that way, they just let taboo be a taboo and don't attend to it or don't want to attend to it.
Yes and no. Yes and no. That's why I was saying that if it's all right, you see a woman and you see ke ghar se kaam karti hai, or she does something that's supplementary to your work, she doesn't hurt your ego in any way. But when she starts becoming some bankers, have an official meeting, he takes it for granted that I will accompany him. But if I, as a banker and a leading banker, have to go for a dinner with him, these mindsets that we have to work towards, and consciously, men and women have to work towards it, because like you very correctly said, it's a mindset change. And that is the longest that it takes to turn it around.
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. I think just to take you on the topic back, where not as the battle of sexes, we were supposed to talk about managing work and family together. But before we leave it only on that, I think the equality notion is just a myth, because God has created two different bodies. So there are two different bodies with two different properties. Like in your movies, a heroine role cannot be played by a hero. There are two different heroine roles cannot be played by a hero. Mm-hmm. So there is a heroine, there is a hero. So there is no equality at all. Equality in terms of respect, rights, equality around taking decisions makes sense. Equality about two bodies is kind of wrong notion.
No, but equality about bodies ki baat kahan kar rahe hain? Physical strength ki baat kar rahe hain?
Physical strength hai, mindset hai. A woman can become mother, and a man cannot. So there is no equality there.
No, but there is definitely biological difference, because biological difference cannot be the fulcrum on which you negotiate a relationship and say that ye jo hai, do alag alag chapters.
If you are mentioning equality about respect, I agree. On rights, I agree. On rights, freedom to take a decision, perfectly alright. Because then it is not about women and men, it is about humanity. It is about every single human. It is not because she is a woman. It is about she is just another human. Just because she is a woman, equality is a wrong notion. That's what I'm trying to say. If it is humanly, everybody should have that right to decide the way she wants to lead his life.
Yes, so I agree. I want to know that if your child is ill at home, will you stay at home or will you take it for granted?
It is between husband and wife. How do we decide? If I'm okay to sit with my children, I will definitely sit. There is no question of not living there. It is about making a decision there If we go together, husband and wife, decide that, okay, she's going to have a class, or if she's a teacher for panic healing, if she has an important task and she's critical to do, she will go and I have to stay. It is in between the compatibility in between husband and wife. It is not because she is a woman and she's supposed to do it.
That's right. So you and I are saying the same thing, basically. You and I are not saying opposite things. We are saying exactly the same thing, that it is a negotiable relationship. Anything is a negotiable relationship. कौन कितना वक्त घर पे खर्च करेगा, कौन कितना बाहर करेगा, कौन कितना समय बच्चों को देगा, कौन नहीं देगा, it's a negotiable thing. It cannot be done by dint of the fact that this is one gender that does it and this is the other gender. That's exactly what I'm saying. Correct.
Hi ma'am. I'll try and continue with the question of Ajaya and Madhur. There are certain inequalities in terms of the practices which are being followed. Let's say, you know, mother spoke about raising our children, both sons and daughters, equally. But why does a daughter have to go away after marriage? I mean, and why not a son? I'm coming from father.
Let me tell you, my father, if he could help it, he would include himself also in the dahej. Ke main bhi saath ekadat, kitni saari hai ekadat baap. He used to always say, no, why should the girl have to go away? In fact, this whole notion of the paraya dhan comes from this. Ke ladki ब्याह के दूसरे घर चली जाएगी एंड वंस शी गोज टू द अदर हाउस देन वी हैव नथिंग टू डू विद हर व्हिच इज कंप्लीटली फ्लॉड अकॉर्डिंग टू मी एंड व्हिच इज द रीजन व्हाई सो मेनी गर्ल्स एक्सेप्ट वायलेंस इन देयर होम्स बिकॉज दे वी डोंट हैव अ स्टेट दैट गिव्स अस एनी राइट्स वी डोंट हैव अ स्टेट दैट कैन लुक आफ्टर आवर चिल्ड्रन सो इफ इट्स अ सिचुएशन लाइक दैट सी हाउ ऑफन इट हैपेंस दैट अ वुमन gets into a situation जहाँ उसके साथ violence होता है and when she wants to come back to her parents' home, her parents say, नहीं नहीं बेटा you can't come back, हमारी बहुत बदनामी हो जाएगी, तो जो छोटी बेटी है उसकी भी शादी नहीं होनी. अरे भाई शादी तो उस मर्द की भी होनी चाहिए जिसने लड़की के साथ ऐसे किया, उसकी दोबारा फिर से शादी हो जाती. It's a very skewed way of thinking and that's why I say that it is very important for parents never to consider their daughters as parayadhan. But to say that our house is as wide open for you as it is for the son. And basically, I think both son and daughter should not give it to parents. Right?
Good evening, Shivani. It's a wonderful talk so far. I have two questions, actually. It's one thing about managing work and family. When it comes to managing a marriage, so there will be situations where you get into arguments, where you have the fights. So in such situations, if you come to the level of being an equal, and if one person does not decide or does not choose to be the quieter one in the relationship, where will this lead to the marriage? My second query is, I have a daughter, she goes to school, but the kind of situation that's there in society today, even if she's going to school and coming back, the constant fear is for her to come back safe to me. And the law and orders in the hands of people who make these comments every second day, which we all laugh at. But the problem is that no solution is coming to that. And how do we feel safe at the end of the day?
So, you know, it's a very it's an extremely important question. I was only 9 years old when my mother, we shifted from where we were and came very far away in Juhu in Bombay. And I said, no, I will go to the same school. I'm not going to change my school. The school was almost 14 kilometers away from where we had come. And my mother used to send me alone. I used to take a bus, go 25 minutes by bus alone. Then after that, I used to take a train, which was another half an hour ride alone. And after that, there was a 20-minute walk to the school. And I really marveled. She sent a maid with me for about 3 months when I was 9. And then I did it all on my own. And I just keep telling her, I said, how did you have the guts to do it? But the times were very much more safe. In today's day and age, I don't think I'd be able to do that. And so this question of women's safety is a very, very important question. And it has to be taken extremely, very seriously. Our politicians do, the comments that they make are not laughable. They are extremely revolting. Statements that they make, and constantly they are making it. And if you know, in the wake of the Nirbhaya tragedy, when you would have expected that they would have all come together, look at the kind of comments that they were making. It's a very horrifying state, absolutely. And that is a concern which, if as a society and if as our, as the people who are in politics don't take seriously, it's a matter of very deep concern. But the thing is to build confidence in the child, to make her aware, to make her very sharp, right from the word go, okay, you know, we don't prepare our children for anything that is untoward. I think a time comes when we can do that. But it is a question that needs addressing. When it comes to an argument between a husband and wife and a spouse, I again think that there's no legislation. It's one of the partners will have to adjust, not every time, sometimes you and sometimes they. Like for instance, in my own relationship with Jari, there have been times when we've got into an argument, but we've made one pact, one that we will never go to bed on a fight. So that, you drop it. We say to each other, drop it. And it works like magic. So you drop it then. And then maybe 10 days later, you don't let it go. 10 days later, when both of you are in a more calm situation, then you, without getting hysterical and crying and not listening to the other and all that, you can say, na dekho, ye sahi nahi tha. Lekin mujhe aisa lagta hai ki kisi bhi rishte mein, khas taur se miyan biwi ke rishte mein, you know, as long as you are sensitive to the signals of your partner. So sometimes, even when your partner is being unreasonable, if at that moment you feel it's okay, just keep quiet and let it go. It's all right. Provided the partner is also willing to make that concession. It cannot be a routine reaction ke har bar the wife will behave badly and the husband will keep quiet, or har bar the husband will behave badly and the wife will keep quiet because she's a man, but she's a woman and he's a man. You see, it's something that you have to work out between yourselves. But I think it's very important to let a lot of things go as long as you work out the non-negotiables. There have to be certain non-negotiables that you say very clearly without screaming and shouting, saying very firmly that this I will not accept. Ye sab karne ke. To compromise mujhe jo hai, wo koi dirty word nahi lagta. I think it's a way of maturity that you don't make everything into an issue. Then I'll give you an example myself. One day I was going for my shooting and I suddenly just started, I sat down and I started crying. And Javed said, what has happened to you? And I said, look at the state of my curtains. You know, for 6 months I've been wanting to change those curtains and I just haven't got the time. So he said, but I'm not concerned that those curtains have been changed. I said, it's not about you, it's about me. I am house proud and I want that my house should look spick and span. So he said, well, you have to then prioritize. You have to decide what is important and then you have to delegate. If you don't have the time to do it, then you train people around you and people like you, all of you have help around you. You invest in the training and you make sure that somebody else is capable of doing it, or you say this is my priority and this is how I think this whole notion of superwoman is very faulty. And I think women who are efficient are the worst sufferers. Dekhi, agar aap bilkul bewakoof hain aur aapki kuch samajh mein nahi aata, wo mere history batate hain, to aapko kuch karne nahi, aaram se baitho, apni timelines banao, kuch karne ki. The minute you're efficient, you're in trouble. Because then you have to look after your children, you have to look after your husband, you have to look after your in-laws, you have to look after your sister, you have to look after your friends. You have to look after everyone. That is a big problem. It's much more than that. Because I mere samajh mein kuch bhi nahi aata, aisa bhi karta hai mera family ko. But that's the price that you have to pay. Yeah.
I have seen many
times. Just speak loud, I can't hear you.
I have seen many movies of yours, but I've seen in your movies there are many where you're very tolerant lady. You have been suffered by a man in many movies. Yeah, like Earth, where half the movie you've been like tolerating whatever has been happening to you in the movie. And then I remember one more movie wherein there is a song. वो खत मुझे दिला दो. I don't remember the name of the movie. Haan, Big House. Like, not only your movie.
Movie.
Oh, sorry. There are many movies there in this show.
If anything, I'm known for doing films in which the women are strong. So I really haven't suffered.
Example,
I didn't suffer. I suffered for a bit, but that's not what the movie was about. That was about a woman's independent spirit and having the guts to say no to her husband after he said yes.
That's what I'm trying to, like, my question is still about to come. So, but then, nowadays what I'm seeing is, there are many, many serials which have been come up. I just happened to watch a serial wherein a well-educated lady, and they're showing that her tolerance level is so, so high that she's keeping quiet for everything which is happening to her. Is this what a woman has to be? Or
why do these serials have the TRPs that they have? Why is it that women are running to watch these serials? Agar, if we seriously want a change, then how can we patronize? How can we patronize a certain kind of film, a certain kind of theatre, a certain kind of television, and then say, aisa kyun banta hai? Aap dekhi mat. Aapko koi force karta hai? Koi force karta hai kya? Magar hum toh wohi dekh rahe. Aur jab hum dekhenge toh woh perpetuate hoga, woh mein. That's why I am saying that it is as much, the filmmaker obviously have to do soul searching. And they have to work with it. But the audiences also have to reject things which they find unpalatable. That's important. Yeah.
Very good evening. Very good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, the patriarchal mindset that you're talking about, I'm just considering the bargaining power of a man versus a woman in a relationship. Do you think much of the excess bargaining power given to a man in our country is by virtue of him being presupposed as the breadwinner of the family?
Yes.
For example, I have two daughters. Would you say that I should bring them up in such a way that they would know that as adults, they would be responsible for half of the running of the house financially? And would that be a contributing factor to the amount of respect that they can have and bargaining power that they can have?
It's a wonderful question, and in your question is the answer. You're absolutely right. The bargaining power comes from the notion that he is the breadwinner. And so if we bring up our daughters to believe that the sole end of the purpose of their life is not just to get married, but also to be independent and stand on their own feet, that will definitely make a difference. Now, I work in a small village in Mijwa and Azamgarh, where I work with underprivileged women. And the fact was, you know how UP is. And the mindset was really that girls did work given times of day. Now we taught them skills, we taught them chicken curry, we taught them the computer, and these women are now earning money. The power equations have shifted within the family, because now this woman is no longer earning her own money and she has her own bank account. She's also giving money to the husband for things that he needs. And so that is shifting the power equation within the family. And so certainly I would say that raise your daughters to believe that they should be contributing partners to the economy of the family, and that would be wonderful.
Thank you.
Madam Azmi, hi. Good evening. I'm Sharad Mishra, and I don't have a question, but I have certain information which I wanted to share with you. I'm taking you back on the question where you were mentioning about the Nirbhaya grant. So when this was happening in India, I was
I can't hear what you're saying. Just speak into the mic, please.
Yeah. Basically, I'm taking you back on the question in which you were answering and you were mentioning about Nirbhaya grant. So when this was happening in India, I was part of a conversation where some retired high court judges were talking about it. And it shook me the way they were talking about it, they were all wanting to discuss why it is happening. So when I came back home, I was really thinking about it, and I realized that I should gather some information. So in RTI, I applied to all the chief secretaries in India, and I wanted to know how many, gang rapes have happened in the states. And what I've gathered, because I'm submitting this information to you since you are MP in Rajya Sabha, you can always take this forward. I have received in the last 1.5 years, or probably the period in which I have applied, answers only from five states, and in all the five states, people who were involved in these gang rape cases are Hindus. And when I try to dig myself, you know, why this is happening. So I think the basic problem is into the character of the society, you know, because the education system has become so weak that people are getting characterized, and the character building is happening through Asaram Babu or Nirmal Baba, and you know, these are the people who are basically trying to build the character of the society. So why can't we in India have some practical laws which can, help us get away from these Babaji's, and we can do some creative system where we can try to create character of the society, that even if somebody is trying to serve me in cinema, probably, as you mentioned, a heretic song or item number, you know, people should take it as the way it is being served and forget about it. So why can't, since you are in, sitting in a place where you are making laws also, so I'm really, confused why it is not happening in our country.
No, because sadhyon ki ek prata chali aa rahi hai, wo ek saal ke andar thodi change ho jayegi. The fact is, that's why I am attacking the patriarchal mindset. It takes years and years and years. Because in terms of laws, we have very good laws. But implementation is a problem. Look at what happens. If a girl is raped, she goes into a police station. There are a series of questioning that she is made to answer, which is like a second verbal rape. Uske baad then she goes into court, the kind of questions that are asked is a third rape. So the way the insensitivity with which rape victims are treated, that has to change. That cannot happen through legislation, although legislation is happening. We are now saying, the Justice Verma Committee said that there should be a protocol. It should be videotaped. How the policeman is asking her questions, that needs to be videotaped. She has to be treated with the utmost compassion. But recently, I'm talking only about last year, in the area in and around Delhi, there was a sting operation conducted on 100 SHOs, 100, mind you. And out of those 100, 93 of them said, ye aurat jo hai na jo aake batati hai ki she's been raped, ye ya to ye tawaif hai, and she's trying to blow money, or she's from the, no decent girl will ever come and say that she has been raped. Now this is the head of the police station. And if this is how he thinks, how is it going to be possible for a girl who has who's gone through such a traumatic experience that she can actually go and even make a complaint? It's again a mindset change, and now there are very clear laws according to Justice Verma which have been put into place, including videotaping. But again, this is, we are talking about after the incident has taken place. The incident shouldn't take place. I remember that I was working in Singapore, and at 1 o'clock in the night, I would take a taxi and I would be not at all afraid, and I would say, this should be the given. The way, you see, what is also happening, you have to see that in our society, as women are becoming more empowered, as they are going out into the work sector, they are doing so much more work, there is also backlash to try and send them back. So there are so many girls who work in back offices, raat mein 4 baje unka kaam khatam hota hai. Hamari jo street lighting, is tarah ki street lighting? We don't even have something as simple as street lighting that we should have. So I feel that jitna attention hamare political classes ko seriously is par dena chahiye, wo nahi dete, that's a very big problem.
Right, any last question from parents? Parents? Parents are here?
Madhu, can I ask one? Ma'am, it's not really a question, but it's a request. I'm a great admirer of your work. I've always admired you, you're talented, you're bold, you're beautiful. You've lived up to the life as your principles, as what you're telling us about. Would you ever consider writing a book about yourself?
You know, I have been, yeah, there have been lots of publishers who've told me that, and it is something that I need to do. I'm just very busy, but at some point I certainly will.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank the audience. I want to also request all of you that support, please fill in the feedback forms and rate this experience that you had today. This is as important to give feedback also and to help us in future. I want to invite the board on the stage to have a photograph with the eminent speaker, Madam Azmi. The board.
Thank you. Thank you.